Assalamu alaikum everyone. Hope you're doing fine, inshallah. As you can see, I'm up here on this hill. Such a beautiful weather today, inshallah. It's not too hot. A little bit windy, but it's beautiful. Inshallah, I wish I brought my shorts with me so I can go and just jump in the water. Anyway, how is everyone doing? Inshallah, I will be speaking to the Salam Charity team on the ground in Beirut. So I will wait for their request from Salam Charity UK, and then we have a chit chat and see, inshallah, the situation over there. If I'm not mistaken, they were supposed to do some distribution of some things, I think. Let's see if I have the... here we go. Okay, I'm adding Salam Charity. Let's see who's there. Connecting. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam. Wa barakatuh. Kif al hal?
Alhamdulillah. Kifak?
Alhamdulillah. Tamam. Alhamdulillah. Hanahki Arabi wala English?
بدك اياه.
We can mix شوي لانه I think في ناس كثير ما يحكوا عربي, بس فينا نعمل الميكس ان شاء الله.
ما مشكلة بنعمل الميكس.
كيف الاحوال؟ كيف الوضع عندكم؟
الاحوال
نعم, عم يروح صوتك شوي بس.
سامعني؟
سامعك بس عم يقطش.
كونكشن كيف شباب؟ لانه انا موجودة I'm in the area, one of the areas that got affected with this blast.
No.
And this COVID test, let me show you. Okay. If you can see those two buildings.
Yeah.
13 yes. Victims.
SubhanAllah.
Right here.
Yeah.
We came here. As Salam Charity for this area need food, they were requesting the families here. People can or humanitarian aid to this area because it's dangerous, still dangerous because the rubble is everywhere.
The what is everywhere?
The rubble.
Rubble, yes.
Are not strong.
Yeah.
And as Salam Charity, we came. Very good food and water, and to see how we can. Because most of us lost a lot here.
It's breaking up, huh? Your voice is breaking up. الصوت عم يقطش شوي.
نعم.
أنا بس نزلت من هونيك لأنه شوي it's a little bit too windy, so maybe it's better when I'm down here شوي. Yeah, tell me.
On the bar. بهدول البنايتين لوحدهم 13 ضحيه, اطفال, نساء, مسنين من كل الاعمار, من هدول البنايتين بس من هذا الحي اللي هو كله دمار. كنت عم بقول لك انه عدد كبير من الجمعيات ما بتقدر توصل لهون بسبب في مخاطر الوصول لهون, لانه البنايات معظمها منا ماكنه وفيها كثير دمار. هلا بنطلع من جوا مثل ما شايف السيارات كمان
سبحان الله
كمان تضررت.
نعم نعم. هلا هون بين البنايات صح؟ يعني
انا موجوده بين البنايات ونحن هون في عائلات موجوده بهيدي البنايات, عم نحاول نقدم لهم مواد اغاثه سريعه, بس انا بدي اطلع وفرجيك بهيدي البنايه مأساة كثير كبيره. مأساة كبيره عن عده شهداء نزلوا, كل واحد منهم قصه, يعني مثل ما بتشوف يعني سبحان الله. There's a lot of pain in this building mainly.
Of course.
You can see blood everywhere. You know
سبحان
this
الله. Yeah. Wow.
And you can hear some still rubbles falling down. If you can.
Yes.
You know this blood? Maybe for us when we take pictures of this blood, we say that it's blood, but you know this blood belongs to human beings.
To human beings.
To a young boy. His name is Tariq. This is his blood. Because did we know his story.
Did he make it or?
He's still in the ICU.
In the hospital.
Always, yes.
Allah yashfi. Allah yashfi.
Ameen. You can see here. Let's enter this house.
You know, that's the whole thing. Subhanallah, when you know when it comes to like this is almost now 2 weeks, right? Like 3 weeks, is it 2 or 3 weeks now?
Yes.
And the whole world was speaking about it for a couple of days. But then, خلاص يعني موضوع بي أكيد something else comes and takes over يعني. But هون بتشوف and you can see, you know, people are still there suffering and the ruins are still there. It's not going to be rebuilt in a couple of يعني, days or months and stuff and weeks, you know, so subhanAllah.
You know, Maher, this is the closest spot for the blast where it happened.
Yeah. Wow.
You know, still something still falling.
No. Yeah, watch out so nothing falls on you.
So far, no.
Yeah.
You know, August 4 was a very tragic day here in Lebanon.
Mm.
And I want to say something about this place. This
yes.
place, it used to have a couple's fiancé and his blood a bit. And they were here in this room when the explosion happened and both died in this room. As you can see, the as you can see, they put some soil or sand on this.
Oh, yes. Is this the balcony or is this a wall or
no,
balcony?
No, this is not a balcony. This is supposed to be a wall with window. Ooh. Like that. Can you see the other wall with that window?
Yes.
Wall used to be here as well.
Mm. Yep.
Not a balcony. This is a wall that got destroyed.
Mm. No. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
And we hear terrible stories all over the place. In every I'll get you on the place. Sorry.
Wow. No, I think this is just showing one picture on one image of what happened to whole Beirut. You know, subhanAllah, it's. And we've seen you know like these drone shots where you can see like a lot of places in Beirut, but I haven't seen anything close to this. Like close in, you know, in قريب يعني الواحد يشوف شيء قريب يعني.
Blood is everywhere, Maher.
Yeah.
And you know this blood for so many victims that fell here. They were supposed to be safe at their home.
Yes, and obviously no one can live there now, and this is just one building out of the many buildings that got hit, and everything looks the same, صح?
Yes.
Wow. Subhanallah.
Here.
Yeah, this could have been any house of ours, subhanallah. Wow. Yeah.
So you know, maybe under this rubble, you see a lot of memories here. There are memories for family. Memories.
Yes,
for human
like pictures. Yes.
A better tomorrow.
Yeah.
And you can see so many things here.
Wow.
And there's a picture of a couple as well.
Tell me, what is Salam Charity doing now on the ground to help? Like, what are you guys doing? So you can tell us and all my listeners.
Yes, Salam Charity since the beginning. Okay, since the beginning of the blast in August 4, Salam Charity, from the first night, was here on the ground with all its team, trying to offer whatever needed as emergency. First, we started with emergency relief, food, ready to eat, because most of the families here lost their houses, lost kitchens, their supplies. So in the beginning, we started to offer them ready-to-eat food, water. Hospitals were overcrowded with injuries, so
there's
no place for more injuries. So those who had minor injuries, they couldn't go to hospital. hospitals because they give the priority to the severe cases. So in the first that there were mobile clinics for the injuries.
Yeah.
And the need for food is really big. You know, Lebanon has been suffering from economical crisis before because of the.
That's one of the saddest part, actually, that this hit. Yani, this is like you hit someone when they're already down. So it's just like you just keep falling and falling and falling, subhanAllah.
Yes, yeah. In Lebanon, since few months, there was an economical crisis, starvation crisis, also the corona virus lockdown. Yes. Lebanon is starting as well. Mm. So with all these crises, this blast came just to add more pain to the suffering of the Lebanese. No. And, you know, I have met so many families here. They were talking that during the war, we didn't witness such things. You know, Lebanon.
Yes, yes, yes.
Passed with so many years of war, but still witnessing right now in Beirut mainly, and in the other areas. This is a tragedy. In every, maybe we can see now human beings because most of them are in hospitals or they are out of their in other place in order to, because they can't bear sitting here in this damaged area. It's dangerous for them. But you know, today we meet a lot of cases that that they appeal for food. Food is a main item that needed during period because starvation crisis started before. What about now? So and also we hear about of kids losing their fathers. And last time I was live with Salam Charity, we met her who lost her mom and two sisters, and the third one at the hospital. So I visited that Diana at the hospital. She told me I was 11 hours under the rubble with my mom. I was trying to save her.
Wow.
Hit her mom and hit Diana's legs. So she told me I tried to make her alive by breathing on her mouth, and then she died. 7 hours staying under the rubble, she died. She was dead. I was hugging and kissing her and telling her, please forgive me, mom. I couldn't. She was only 15 years old. She was telling me so much pain and agony. And also, there's Ibrahim, a boy who lost his dad. He was 12 years old. I met him yesterday as well. He told me, in his innocent way, I used a troublemaker at the house. I used to bother my sisters because I'm the only boy. So my dad used to take me in his car, asking me to be good of my sisters, because one day when he dies, my dad, I am responsible for the family.
Wow.
But he told me, but I am now responsible for the family, but I'm still too young. I'm 12 years old. What shall I do? How can I take? I wish I told my dad that I will take care. I wish I could. So subhanAllah, in every home, there's a misery. There's a pain. There's a story of people affected. You know, trauma as well. Lebanon was facing a big trauma. You know, maybe Beirut will be rebuilt. Maybe Beirut will be rebuilt in a few months, maybe. But still, what about the emotional destruction? The human.
Yes, the scars will live forever.
Yes, Maher. So, subhanAllah, this is really, really very sad. Being on the ground since the beginning of the blast till now makes us feel that this destruction is not just statistics or number of people, of martyrs who got this. Part of these buildings.
Wow. No, I think it's very hard, you know, for us who are not there to feel, you know, we can feel bad about it, but we can never understand fully, like, you know, the impact that it has on the people there.
Yes, yes.
Wow. Yes, subhanAllah. Yes, mashallah, I'm so happy that, you know, for what you're doing.
If possible, I want you to be someone who lost two family members. I want you to meet Mrs. Nohad. Mrs. Nohad, can you tell us about your misery, about what happened?
Yes, we lost my nephew. He's 1 year old.
فيك تحكي عربي، فيك تحكي انجليزي، ما مشكلة. ماهر لبناني فحيقدر.
ايه ما في مشكلة، ما في مشكلة.
Okay, she will take me to the place where they died. Was the pain still big?
Of course, of course.
ماهر هو لبناني. This is all the, she's saying this is their blood everywhere. Okay. Okay, نحن عم نسمعك. تفضلي.
جاك ونيكول كانوا شبه خايفين، كانوا قاعدين بالبيت هون. بس طلع الدخن السوداء الحريقة اجوا وقفوا هون، هون كان في حل شبه. بحكي مع أصحابه على الوقت أمس إنه في حريق، في طيران، اجوا أصحابه وشافوا. بعد شوي طلع جاب كثير أحزاني.
They were here on this ground. Yeah. Nicole were here. Was here. And Jack was here. Okay. اختنا شو 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 شعورك يعني الامور اللي صارت؟ قديش الوجع عندك؟ اذا بدك يملى ميه ما بقدر.
انا دغري حسيت انه في شيء خطير لانه انقطع حس جاك من بعد الانفجار الكبير، ما عدنا سمعنا صوته على الواتساب، ندق له ما يرد. قام ابني وركض على المنطقة، وصل لتحت لأنه ما في سيارات تفوت من الردم، ركض فوق الردم ورجع لقي هون غرقان بدمهم وميتين اثنيناتهم. كانت المأساة الكبيرة وصار الشاشة مع الفيديو اللي شفناهم فيه.
قد ايه صعب عليك اللي صار؟
كثير ما عم بقدر اتحمل، ما عم بقدر انسى، لأنه كان عايش معنا هو. ترك ونزل الساعة 4:30، قدر وعيط له مش قدر. هول المجرمين اللي تركوا المتفجرات بيناتهم.
يا حلول قتل.
كان فيهم يتفادوا هدول الضحايا كلهم، 200 ضحية، مش حرام؟ مش حرام؟
أكيد.
طب كنا بدنا نجوز المفتردات بيناتهم.
الله يصبركم ويقويكم، لانه عن جد يعني ما بعتقد حدا في يعني يستوعب اللي انتم عم تمروا فيه. الله سبحان الله، الله يقويكم.
ما شيء ما بينطق جريمه ضد الانسانيه، حرام العالم هيك يموتوا ببيوتهم، ما في قضيه يموتوا كرمالها، مش عم بيحاربوا على الجبهه وماتوا، هن ببيتنا اكثر مكان الامان لنا بيتنا، اجى الموت لعندهم على البيت. كثير صعب نتقبل، كثير صعب.
سبحان الله، الله يقويكم، الله يقويكم، الله يصبركم، يكون معكم. يعني مرحلة يعني مرحلة الحياة صعبة كثير يعني. والله ما بعرف، أنا ما بعرف صراحة شو بدي أقول. والله
there's a lot of stories here. Everywhere you can hear a story, a sad story about human beings. Everyone they what doing. Kids talking in a very innocent way about what happened. سبحان الله، what happened to Lebanon is really a big catastrophe and we don't know for how long this will stay. This all this pain and destruction everywhere.
Yeah. سبحان الله. Anyway, thank you so much, Ihan, for taking your time to speak with me, and may Allah bless you for your work on the ground. And we're trying to do whatever we can from here to help as well. And may Allah make you strong, and we pray for Lebanon every day, and Beirut, and all the families, and all the victims. SubhanAllah, may Allah make it easy on all of us, and all of you.
Okay, Maher, thank you very much for being with us, and thank you for your support, your continuous support.
Thank you so much, thank you, and, thank you.
Inshallah, we'll see you in Beirut.
Inshallah, I hope that it's going to be possible, because I really want to come, inshallah.
Inshallah, thank you very much.
Shukran, thank you so much, and jazakumullah khair. Yalla, bye bye. Salam, salam. Wow, I'm speechless. Really, I don't know what to say. I just spoke to a woman, as you saw, that she lost family members. And you could just tell and see the pain and hear it in her voice. And I think we could never imagine, yani imagine she's coming there and seeing her family members just lying there, you know, I don't know. Subhanallah. Anyway, we just wanted to show you a little bit of what's going on in the ground. You know, as I said before, the news covers tragedies and wars and etc. like something that's interesting for a day or two, and then they move on, something else comes and replace it. But as you can see, this is 3 weeks, I think now, 3 weeks ago when it happened. And yani, this is not going to be over in a while. You know, it's going to take a long time to rebuild all the houses, all the homes. And not just that, you can never get back family members that have passed away. So, we can only do whatever we can do, but the least we can do is to pray for these people and the families, and at least keep them in our minds, in our hearts, you know. So, yeah, that's about it. Just wanted to speak a little bit with someone, and so you can see, and we keep in touch, inshallah. Take care for now, and I see you, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.